My name is Nais Nailante Lengete and I'm 23 years old. I'm born in Loitoktok Sub County in a place known as Kimana Village. And I'm working with AMREF under the Alternative Rights of Passage program as a project officer. My journey started when I lost my parents on a difference of 1 year. I lost my father in 1997 and I lost my mother in 1998. And our uncle came to our grandfather's home. And he told our grandfather, because even him himself, he was circumcising her three daughters, he said that because, you know, when you do it differently, the cost will be high. Because doing those ceremony for circumcision is very expensive because they have to buy cattle, goats to slaughter, they buy rice and everything so that people are going to celebrate on that day. I was very young for me by that time. I was still 8 years old. And I knew very well I cannot undergo it without crying. It's like a taboo when you cry and you're being circumcised. There is no any man who is going to marry you from that community. And the other thing is that, leave alone even crying, even moving your own eyes or moving your body, you're called a coward. And when the day reached, we woke up at 4 a.m. in the morning because they usually do around that time, 4:30 to 5. They don't do it when the sun is out. So we just went outside his home and there was a big tree and we stayed up there up to around 6 a.m. in the morning. And we walked up to our aunt's home. And from there, it's almost, I think, more than 20 kilometers, but we walked. And we were beaten, we were threatened and all that. And I told my grandfather, me, I don't want to be circumcised. I was in a boarding school when I was young, so I could hear people talking badly about it. They are saying it's something that is very painful and it's not done in their communities. So as much as I knew that something that is a must in my community, but I was like, other communities are not doing it and they're in school. And our girls who are being circumcised are not in school, where are they going? It's just because after circumcision, you have to be married off. Female circumcision in Maasai culture, it's what makes you to be a woman. Even if you are 30 years old, even if you are 40 years old, you are still a girl. Because for them, cutting off the clitoris is something they value so much. It's what makes you to be a woman. And you know, once you are circumcised, you can do now what a woman can. What women are allowed to do. If it's having sex, you're allowed to have sex. If it's being married off, or even if you are 12 or even if you are 30, but you are a woman. When I grow up, I want to know about it and I want to go back and tell other girls the effects of female genital cutting. AMREF, they were working within our communities, so they came to our village and they said they have a peer education training and they need one boy and one girl. So by that time I was the only girl who has gone to school in my community. So I said now for women I can talk to them.
Because if you are circumcised, the status removed, and then if the status removed, if it's the motorbike with no status.
So I knew that there it's easy and it was easier for me. But I said that there are these other groups that we need. Cultural elders, they are the decision makers. These morans, they are the ones who are the future husband of these younger girls. So even if we tell everyone about female genital cutting and we are not involving these two groups, we are not doing anything. Even elders were wondering, this girl, how you know, she knows very well you are not allowed to speak with men. After some time, they called me, and they called one of the chiefs, the leader of the morans, and he told them that, we don't know what this girl want to tell you, but you have to go and listen. I had something in my mind that I said that, let me just keep on trying. And later on, they accepted me. And they started, we started a dialogue like that. They became open and the dialogue started. We could now discuss about FGM, child marriage and all that.
It's a revolution. It's a new thing. Because in the past, they have practiced, even our mothers, they undergone circumcision. But now, starting from our generation, we are getting uncircumcised ladies. So it's another new thing that we are undergoing. Yeah.
In December, through the alternative rites of passage ceremonies, we trained 621 girls whom we are still monitoring them in schools. And so far, we know all of them are still in school. We organized a 2-day training and a 1-day ceremony for the girls. It's simply girls growing into women without a cut. So for the 2 days, we really talk to them. We have group discussions. They draw anatomy. They just know every part in their bodies, what it means, what it is for. And we also go to an extent of telling them, as girls, they have also a right to choose whom and when to marry. We bring old men. They advise them. They talk to them. We also bring the younger morans. They also have to come and give them a surety that we are going to marry you without being circumcised. So everyone is there. On the third day, that is now when we do the usual ceremonies, like the ones we are doing when we are having circumcision. But the difference that is there in our alternative rites of passage ceremony is that the cut is not there. So they go around blessing girls, doing that. You know, before they used to bless you when you are being circumcised, and they tell you, we are blessing you, you can give birth to many children, we are blessing you to go and take care of your husband, be a wife who is respected and all that. But in that day, it's a special day because they are blessing them with their pens and their books and pencils. We are blessing you. Go to school, focus on your education, concentrate. We want you to become lawyers, we want you to become doctors, we want you to become president of this country. Through education, you can become the woman of your dreams.
When I grow up, I will be a doctor, helping our communities and our friends. Thank you.
When I grow up, I want to be a pilot. Because when you be a pilot, you can learn many things out of our country and many others.
Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it. Let us save our girls. Let us save our girls.
I just want to tell everyone that you can change the world. You have that time. And you have that time. And you, if you get that chance to change the world or to change communities or to change harmful traditional practices, don't waste your time. Go for it, because there are people who are there who are suffering, who are crying for change, and there's no one who is telling them that this is the way to go.
Happy dog is